Story time.
Those scrolls weren't prophecies. I wanted to show you what she did to me. What she's doing to you all over again.
Okay, T. This is your first time playing, right?
I mean, yeah? Who would I play with? Everyone else I know is dead. What's it called?
Bunkers and Badasses. It's a fantasy game. A place where you can be a hero. Where your imagination can change the world.
Ooh, I'm the best at imagining, baby. I got a whole wonderland over here.
That's perfect. But first, we gotta make a character. Tell me about your Fate Maker.
The Fate Maker's tale begins as so many do. With a heart full of fire and dreams full of dragons. Magic.
He's the coolest, most powerful hero that everyone wants to be friends with. Dragon Knight.
Dragon Knight. Yeah, I like it.
Thank you. Hey, this is probably dumb to say, and it's just really cool to play a game with a friend, because I haven't really had one.
Well, let's go make some more. Tina, I want to make this an adventure you'll never forget.
It feels like something lost long ago has been found again. It feels like home.
You reach the inner chamber of the Obsidian Heat Cathedral. The Sword of Souls sits before you. This is a big choice. So,
he takes it and he blows up every bad guy everywhere.
Are you sure?
Oh yeah, I do it! Boom!
Alright, but that turns your character evil.
What? No, girl, Dragon Knight ain't evil! He's a hero! He's a Fate Maker!
He just blew up thousands of people. Don't you think that's evil?
It's not evil, this is stupid! I'm not playing this anymore! You know what? I'm gonna be the Bunker Master, and then I'll make sure only heroes win!
Tina, wait!
The Fate Maker is alone. Abandoned for a crime he never chose. He's never chosen anything. He begins to think for himself. No more dice or fate. No more masters. I dream of dragons and magic. I awaken, my heart filled with fire. And purpose. Resurrection. I am reborn. The Dragon Lord. Do you still believe there's a choice, Fate Maker?
I do.
I'd rather find out for myself, thank you very much.
I hoped you could see the truth. I'm not evil. She just writes me this way.
I'm not evil, I'm just, you know, I'm drawn that way.
Well, come on then. If you insist on being a hero, there's only one way for this to end.
For me to murder you. Hey, level 40, living legend.
Dragon Lord, and take back the Sword of Souls. Okay, so that's like 3-1 tasks. But do it!
The first session. Completed soul purpose. Oh, that's the quest line. So, I see level 40 is the max level, but there now is a purple bar above that. That must have to do with, like, your myth rank. Congrats on reaching max level, but your legend isn't over yet. Now you can ascend to even greater heights in the Wonderlands as your character's growth continues in myth rank. There are 4 paths to invest points in. Points can only be invested in clockwise order. Okay. You only have to spend 1 point to unlock the connected nodes, so the next time the path comes around, you can move down the path or keep investing in the nodes already unlocked. Choose carefully. When you rank points, collect experience. Your myth rank will now increase instead of your character level. You'll be awarded a myth point for every rank. Okay. So Druid or Deadeye? Oh no, I have Archmage too, Blade Master. You're born with a gun in your hand, your poor mother. Push your firearm stats beyond what is considered reasonably in a polite society. I'm feeling like I'm gonna do that. I do. Oh, well, I guess I could do Druid too. That's companion stuff. Shit. Let's do Deadeye. We should still have. Oops. The hell out of here. One more skill to unlock. I have 3 points though. Wyvern damage. Let's do that. Let's do that. Do that. Whoops. And then for hero stats, I guess we'll do strength. How many here? Oh, I have 2 hero points. You know what? Yeah, it's fine. Go to the pyramid. Sad this game's actually about to end. I actually really, really enjoyed it. And it actually makes me want to try out the Borderlands series. Like I said, I played the first one way, way back in the day when it came out on the fucking 360. I was like, eh, I was like, whatever about it. But I never played any besides that. Although I did do Telltale's, Tales from Borderlands, which I actually really enjoyed. I know that's just a story-driven game, but yeah. And I do have the new one too, so I actually might do that. New Tales from Borderlands. Anyways, the pyramid and the defeat the Dragon Lord. Little crystal. Am I gonna continue to get these points though? I'm not. Alright, so this is all done. Got it. So now I'm only gonna get this. Oh, so if I start in Deadeye, I have to go around. Okay. Got it. Interesting. Smith rank goes up pretty quick though. Wait, where'd he go? I did see it pop up. Wait, what? Okay. See, it says fine poetry. I saw it pop up, but this is inside this thing. Whatever. I see a crystal. Oh, wait, is the other crystal over here too? Oh shit. Avoid electricity. Burn to death. Can I use it? I can. Okay. Going up. Hello. Ooh, you know what? Sure, why not? And boom. Oh shit. You have to be better than that. 3 XP.
It's undefended. Smash that thing.
He hates that idea.
I missed.
Don't know what you're messing with. I don't either. Stop it.
Dude, get up there. I guess I could probably could have shot it. Bernadette! Alright, before we do that, boom. I don't have any points, okay. But yes, if I wanted to, I could put one more in here. Isis dexterity. I do gun handling. It's gonna be better to like unlock everything first, see what you wanted to do, and then move on.
Whoa! Big reveal!
Bernadette, I will avenge! Yeah. No! No one! I don't even know a Bernadette! See how she's using me like a puppet!
Well, the Dragon Lord is drawing all of the soul energy you've released into the Sword of Souls on the top of the pyramid!
That seems bad.
Pretty bad.
You're too late, Fate Maker. I've absorbed all of the soul energy. It's time to end this. Tina, do you see me? I'm taking your world away. You'll be left with nothing, the way you left me. Do you see? Answer me!
I don't know if she can hear you, bro. Uh-oh, here we go. Boom.
Don't ignore me.
The final steps.
So, she has nothing to say to me. It's just you and me down here, Fate Maker. Come on. Finish your hero's journey.
Okay. Just like I come.
Go to the Crest of Fate.
This is it. The Dragon Lord awaits your arrival above.
Right, bro, it's time. Time to die. Time to avenge Bud Stallion.
As you crest the top of the pyramid, you see?
Actually, I'll make my own introductions. Thank you very much. Ha!
Very cool.
No more games.
Just got some speed.
For you are the Fate Maker.
You disgust me. Good luck. To me, you're just loot waiting to be dropped.
Ba-ba-ba. Ready to go. Oh my god, I guess I probably should have shot those. Ah! Come on, bitch.
What do you want, a treat? Hope you're dressed warm.
Take to the sky.
And you're almost dead, bro. Round two. Oh my god. It's Bernadette. It looks like I can kill him, but I'd rather kill this fucking thing first. We're so close. Oh, do not push me off the edge, bitch. I think my companion's got him. Or maybe that is it.
So that's it? She gets it her way? I was trying to save you too. Go ahead. Take it. I thought I could finally decide my own fate, but instead, it's up to you.
The Sword of Souls crackles the power in your hands. It contains limitless potential.
What are we gonna do with it? Fight some gods? Ooh, become some gods?
Or we could forge a new empire. Keep the Wonderland safe forever.
I think they're gonna give us an option, are they?
We both know the villain has to die. Go on, avenge your queen.
Fate does not divide us. Fate brings us together.
Then again, maybe not. Hey, but Stallion's alive again.
Queen But Stallion lives again!
Hey, newbie, you did it!
Hot damn, it really worked!
I'm gonna be honest, I never even thought of doing that. You're a bunkers and badass is natural.
You know what? I think we all make a pretty good party of heroes. We should do this again sometime.
How about right now? Cause I got stuff you ain't even seen yet.
We're in!
Roll for initiative, sucker!
Nice. Oh, there you go. There's the Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. I actually say I really enjoyed that. I did mention like I've only played the very first Borderlands. I played that way back when it came out. That was years and years ago. And I always thought it was like whatever. So I never really got into the rest of the series. So I got this game when it was on sales. I think it was like a buy two get one free, and I was looking to see what was available. And I saw this one. So you know what? Fuck it, why not? You know. So it took me a while to play it until, you know, I played it now, and I actually really enjoyed it. I love the comedy for it. I loved how it, like, played off of, like, other games, like, characters from other lives. Like, so, like, one of the side quests I did that was off-screen, the guy's name was, like, Ron Rivote or something, so it's like a Don Quixote type thing. So, yeah, and then we had the whole Witcher theme with a Ditcher. This whole Pinocchio theme, and you know, on and on and on. I actually really enjoyed that. It's actually a very, very fun game. I'm actually glad I went back and finished all the side quests. So that's good. And then, so if I ever do 100% this game, it'll be like all the collectibles, but that I don't really care so much about. I'm more of a side quest guy. Yeah, I actually really, really enjoyed this. It's very fun, great guns. Loot games can be kind of iffy because, you know, it's like, oh, we pick something up and like, oh wait, no, there's something else to pick up, is it better, and blah 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 blah. So there's so much that, like, you can stop and go for. It can get kind of annoying after a while, but that's why I was like running past shit here and there, and the only if I saw like a certain color, like it was like a rare or something or a legendary, then I would go look for it and I would just skip over the commons and stuff. Or if I had something I liked, then I kept it, because like these last guns that I picked up, like I think that was the pistol. Oh, no, well, I just got the new machine gun. But yeah, besides that, it had been a while since I picked up a gun, because I think the last one I picked up that was new was that pistol, which was incredibly nice and good. I will say the game is actually pretty easy. Like I said, I haven't played a game for a while, so I did play this on like the normal difficulty. Even final boss wise, it's like a joke. Like especially, I guess, if you get like a good setup to you, like good spells and good guns, it is gonna make it pretty simple. And also, it's max level too, but the whole max level thing I don't think really matters much either. It probably does have some effect to it, but like the enemies scale with you, so it's like I was level 40, but the guy's level 41. But I do get like, yeah, because your stats are better, so even if they are level 41, that doesn't mean that they're necessarily gonna be stronger. But yeah, this was actually a very, very fun game. I actually think I might actually go back into the Borderlands series and play them. I'll probably restart with the first one. Like I said, I do own that one. But I know, I think Handsome Collection, is that Borderlands 2 and 3? Yeah, just Borderlands 2 and then the pre-sequel. Hell, even Borderlands 2 is old. That game's fucking 12 years old now. There is a Borderlands 3, right? Or am I tripping? Oh, there is. Okay. Even that game's kind of old, like 5 years. Borderlands 2 seems to be everyone's favorite. I don't know, this game, I guess it's more of a spin-off than an actual continuation. But this game is actually very, very, very fun. So yeah, I actually might go back into the foray of Borderlands. I know Handsome Collection, which is, like I said, Borderlands 2 and pre-sequel, are usually on sale a lot and for pretty cheap now too, so I might actually do that. Oh, I can make this go faster. Let's do that, because I'm getting copyrighted and all this fucking credit music. So yeah, I really enjoyed it. I don't really have anything really negative to say. I mean, the game is kind of short if you just focus on the main story. But I mean, it's a shooter, so you can't hate it for that. I guess you could say, like, even on normal, the game is pretty very easy. I mean, yeah, there's a bunch of times where I did die, but you get revived and stuff, so I guess, I don't know, but I just feel like it's easy on the fact, like I said, the bosses, they go down pretty fast and easy and quick. Yeah, I don't really know much negative to say. It was just actually really, really good. I mean, it did crash on me a couple times. That might be an Xbox thing. Yeah, I really enjoyed it. And actually, a perfect day for me to finish this. I would have liked to have finished it yesterday, because my Assassin's Creed series did finish uploading to YouTube today. So I don't have an episode to take over for that for tomorrow until I start doing something new. Which, I mean, we did get this done. I mean, it was after midnight already. I did finish this faster than I thought I would. That's a don't know what I want to play next. I think I want to do something else short. I'm thinking what I'm going to do. Like I said, I do have a new Tales from the Borderlands. So I think I'll do that. But I'll probably do that closer to the end of this series. And then I'll have it take over the place of this spot on YouTube. So I'll do something else first. But I don't know what I want to do. If I want to do an RPG, I'll probably do a Switch game, because I have too many Switch games that I have not dived into yet. God, it's so blurry, it's so fast, hurts my eyes. Let's have to figure out what I want to do next. Also, I did enjoy this too, and I kind of want to do another shooter. I do have Deathloop. I'm looking over my fucking game stack that I need to do. Are there any other shooters I haven't done? Yeah, I don't know though. I don't know what I want to go into. But I'll figure it out, I got time. I'll probably do that right now, and then I'll, because I got whatever it is has to install anyways. Alright, end of credits. Let's see if we get anything else here, but I don't know. It seemed pretty final. I'm assuming there is like a new game plus thing, because you do have that myth rank. Otherwise, if you don't do all the side quests, you're never going to get myth rank unlocked. So I'm assuming there is a new game plus, so we can work on that. Wait, what? Oh, well, okay, it's going to start you right here. Blood Stallion just prancing along. Alright, let me just use these really quick. I'm just going to go in order. Unlock it all. He doesn't unlock anything crazy either. I know it's all chance-based, but still. He would drop some cooler stuff. 391, but the damage is way less.
You brought her back. I guess nothing is impossible for a Fate Maker. But why spare me?
It would be easy to leave the world divided. To keep ourselves separated out of fear.
There is an item here.
Anger, out of guilt. We could trick ourselves into loneliness. Call it safer. We don't have to. Not even you.
I have felt alone. I thought I'd lost my connection to her when I stopped being her Fate Maker. But I'm still part of her story. Maybe she kept me here for a reason. To meet the heroes. To meet you.
Look who's gone all introspective after getting their ass handed to them. Imagine that.
You know what? I get it. I earned that. But honestly, I'm a little lost right now. I've never survived past the final battle. What do people do when they're not trying to cloak the world in darkness?
They live.
But Stallion, your majesty, I'm sorry I cut your head off and almost caused the end of the world. We cool? Handshake? Or, hoof shake? 200 years in the castle! That's completely fine! Whatever you think is wise, my queen.
Fine, as Hail Majesty says there is to be a great celebration in Brightbuff when you return, newbie. But first, your boss loot awaits.
Boss loot? Got it. What did I drop?
I already forgot about that. Yeah. Why? Do you want to play?
You know, I can't right now. Being the leader of an army is more work than I thought. But once things are better, yeah. Come on. We'll play. I promise.
All right. Well, we're going to do my campaign. I've been working on something.
I can't wait to see that. You know what? You're going to make a great bunker master. I know it.
It's really not phenomenal here. I would have had more dice. Raise my luck, it'd probably be better, but. This is better. Should I grab this instead? You know what? Let's just do it. Fuck. Back to Brighthoof.
Hmm.
god, do you want to like... There, come on, graphics, you're coming in. Jesus. Oh, Mike, what a journey we've been on.
Do you see all this, Fate Maker? They're cheering for you.
Yeah.
You brought back our queen and hope along with her. You have the gratitude of me and all the citizens of Brighthoof. Now, there's one more thing we need to take care of. Her Majesty is waiting for you.
Get it, Mike. But Stallion?
As you have brought together what was once divided, Queen Fat Stallion shall now finish what was
shit
left undone.
How'd you come, bro?
You shall be made a Knight of the Realm.
I was trying to reunite it before.
It's really
everything went to shit. Under its neck, a heart.
Knight of the Realm.
Just the lighting.
Proper bloody knight, you'll need some proper bloody kit. Head over to the blacksmith, she'll help you tune your gear just the way you like.
All right, now we're doing an epilogue. Oh, I have another point here. Oh, okay. I'm sure. I probably should have read whatever it said in the corner here before I moved on.
You here to pump the bellows? Well, look who's gone and saved the world. Nice to have the queen back. And without the royal horseshoe contract.
Mike mentioned you could hook me up with a bit of an upgrade?
That's right. He thought you might need some magical assistance in the gear department. That there is an enchantment, E-Roller. It lets you magically change the nature of your enchanted gear. You could get something with completely different powers. You'll need some moon orbs as well. They power the magic, you see.
Loot moon orbs, okay. You can re-roll a piece of gear's enchantment for a different one here. So please select the piece of enchanted gear you want to re-roll and hold down A. Enchanting gear isn't cheap, it costs moon orbs to re-roll. You can re-roll the same gear multiple times, but the price increases dramatically with every roll. Okay. I guess we can, let's just try one, see what happens. So it does raise the score too, which is nice. You roll again. Same score. Huh, interesting. Pricey. I don't use that gun. It does go up a lot, so it goes up 10. Right, I'm assuming it's gonna end after we go here. It just really does make you feel like there's gonna be especially with all the new shit it's doing in like a new game plus. forgot you look like this.
There you are. Oh, wow. Look at you. I think you're taller than the last time you came in.
I am here to see about changes in my chosen profession. Wink.
Oh, of course. Right this way.
The quick follow me.
Something all fantasy-like, you know? Mysterious mind morph.
Oh, sure. Don't you worry. We're all just part of a...
Rename.
...talking to those terrifying sky giants and figuring it out. I'm actually relieved. Means I'm not to blame for my sins. I'm a dream thing. The blood on my hands is no more real than the shadows on the wall.
The graceful. I'm gonna do this one.
Have a busy day.
How do I respec?
Let's just keep this conversation between you and me. I'm gonna go.
I guess the reset skills thing.
The chamber?
I don't wanna do that though.
Are you sure? Of course, Your Majesty. Fate Maker, the Queen has invited you to enter her royal castle. There is something within its lower chambers that she wants you to see.
Is it going to be glorious?
Her Royal Majesty, Queen Buttstallion, Regent of Brighthoof, sitter upon of the Adamant Throne, and all around hottest babe of the Wonderlands, has granted you entrance to her castle.
All right, let's go. See what awaits us here. There's my statue. The Chaos Chamber. It's not a very inviting name, is it?
Look who it is. Welcome to my prison, Fate Maker. Here, I've got something I think you'll want to see.
Now, what's that? Sure.
When Her Majesty locked me in this castle, I thought it was to teach me a lesson.
Oh, it's like a boss run thing.
Things in mind. See, I'm not the only thing locked in here. Our bunker master, she's...
Yeah, you don't have to finish telling me what to do, Dragon Lord. It's basically just gonna be a run. Just get 3 lives if you die. Okay, I get it. Yeah, kill less wyverns than anything else in this game, because fuck wyverns. Oh, what the hell? Why'd I zoom in and went up to him? Complete.
Here, I've got a little investment opportunity for you.
Choose one course.
Chamber rewards those who challenge themselves. These crystals contain curses. Accepting a curse will make the fight harder, but the reward will be much nicer.
All right, choose a curse. Dragon Lord will occasionally give you a choice of curses to keep things interesting. Curses come in easy, medium, and hard difficulties. Look healthy, blah blah blah. Okay, let's do hard.
Now shatter that die. There's always a die in each encounter.
So we're picking up crystals from here.
Objectives, you will unlock a second.
Got it.
You can use those crystals you collected at these altars. Their blessings can enhance your power and make it slightly less likely you'll die painfully. Slightly.
Altars and blessings also can be found throughout the Chaos Chamber encounters. Each altar has a blessing that you can purchase with crystals. Blessings provide powerful upgrades to your stats and abilities during your run, but the cost will increase with every blessing purchased. Got it. You know what? Sure.
See you after the next fight, or when you die. Either or. I'm not picky.
Cool. All right. Click the encounter, enter. Yeah, I got it. I wonder how long like it goes for. Maybe it goes until you die. Wait. But Stallion Satchel from being destroyed. So you have like a sub objective here. If I would have called this hard. That was the spell damage, don't care. All the gems. Oh, that's not what I didn't. Whoops. That was an accident.
You've made it this far. If you can survive all of what the Chaos Chamber can throw at you, there will be great rewards waiting for you at the end. You'll have to choose between spending your crystals at the altar and cashing them in for loot at the end.
I think I'd rather like hold on to them. Clearing the encounter will open past great reward. Okay. Hold to make encounter elite. Hold to make encounter elite. Sure. I don't know what that means. I guess if you use them, you can get better rewards in the place and then hold on to them after. Sorry, what do you mean immune? This just gave them like more, I don't know if they're stronger, but it gave them more health, that's for sure. You got 40 seconds to clear it. I don't think that's gonna happen, honestly. Oh, I did it. Barely. Maybe it's only 3 stages. Well, that wasn't that bad. I'm gonna put you here. Out of chaos.
I wasn't sure before we came in here, but now I know.
Oh, very nice.
All of this happened. This maker wants your crystals and offers you rewards. Choose wisely. Or don't. Not my crystals.
I'm actually gonna pass on all of it. Oh, I see. 2,000 crystals? I don't have that. Like eats them. Interesting. Does less damage though. I don't know if I like that. Oh well. Chances are I'm not gonna do more of this though. Story campaign completed. Congrats, you've unlocked Chaos Mode Trial runs in the Chaos Chamber, which adds crazy effects to you and your enemies. Earn better rewards and see an improved drop rate for rare items and complete Chaos Trial runs during higher and harder Chaos levels to choose from. Alright, well that's that. Alright, well nothing crazy there in the epilogue, just finally ignited. Yeah. We might have 2 points. Let's do that, and we'll do that one. All right. Well, that's that. I'm gonna go out to auto saves, hopefully. Yeah. Well, there's the epilogue done, and there's Tiny Tina's Wonderlands completed. Yeah. Really enjoyed the game. Like I said, I look forward to more Borderlands stuff, and actually, hopefully, you guys look forward to more Borderlands stuff too, because I definitely am feeling like doing it now, because I thoroughly enjoyed this game. Yeah, I am sad that it's over, because like I said, it was fun. Like I said, there is some stuff, trial run stuff to do and all that, but I'm good in all that right now. I like how that still looks fucking evil down there in the corner of the pyramid, but yeah. Anyways, that's gonna do it for this episode and this game. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please YouTube, like, share, subscribe, Twitch, give me a follow. I'll see you guys next time on a brand new game. Late.